So now we are studying the new topic, which is the capacitors. So what is the capacitor? Simply, the capacitor is a device which is used for storing the charges. So there are parallel plate capacitors. So these are the two plates of the capacitor. This is one plate, this is the other plate. These are the two plates of the capacitor. These two plates are connected with the battery, which has a potential difference, positive terminal and negative terminal. This is positive terminal, this is the negative terminal. This is the battery. It means these are the two plates which are connected with the battery. So the plate which is connected with the positive terminal becomes a positively charged plate. This is because of the induced charges. And the negative terminal will charge up the plate on the negatively charged. So here, if you look here, the electric field will be between the plates, which is from the positive terminal to the negative terminal. This is the direction of the electric field between the plates. So as a resultant, this plate becomes a positively charged plate. This plate becomes a negatively charged plate because this is connected with the positive and this is connected to the negative. So there is an electric field between positive to negative plates. We have to look at what is the electric field between the plates, first thing. Second thing, how much charges are stored on the plates of the capacitor, so which we have to see. According to the theory, the charges on each plate, is directly proportional to the applied voltage. So this charges on each plate, Q is the amount of charges on each plate. This is positive Q and this is the negative Q. So this Q, charges on each plate, is directly proportional to the applied voltage. So here this Q, you may write it to the small letter Q, is directly proportional to the V. So proportionality is replaced by some constant factor, which we call it as a C. C is known as a capacitance of the capacitor. The capacitance is the constant property which stores the charges, or which is the capability of storing the charges on each plate, and we call it as a capacitance. Capacitance is simply the capability of storing the charges, and it depends upon C is equal to Q upon V by using cross multiplication. So Q is the coulomb and V is the voltage. Coulomb upon voltage, the unit of the capacitance is farad. So it means if the 1 coulomb charge is stored on the plates of the capacitor, when the applied voltage is 1 volt, then the capacitance on plates will be equal to the 1 farad. So this is known as a capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. So now we have to look at what is the electric field between the plates? So this is the how the capacitance varies. So now we are looking at what is the electric field between the plates. Here, the electric field between the plates, according to the Gauss's law, electric line of force passing through a unit area is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. This is the Gauss's law. Electric line of force passing through a unit area is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. So this what we call it as a Gauss's law. So this E is equal E. This integral over dA is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. This integral over dA is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. So here, this E into A is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. So this E is equal to A. This A gives you the total area. Integral over dA gives you the total area. So the E, electric field E, is equal to Q upon this cross multiplication, A goes down 1 upon epsilon naught. This is the charge per unit area. This is the charge per unit area. So this charge per unit area is known as a charge density. So therefore, the electric field E between the plates is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught. This is what we have find out using the Gauss's law. So here, the electric field between the plates E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught. So the electric field between two oppositely charged plates is equal to the sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. Now this is the positive plate, this is the negative plate, so there is a potential delta V between the plates. So this delta V, the potential is equal to work done per unit charge. The potential is defined as the work done per unit charge. So this can be written as delta V is equal to integral from positive to negative. The work done per unit charge is equal to E dot dS. Work is equal to force into displacement. Work is equal to force into displacement. And here the work is the force into displacement. Okay. This force is equal to Q into E dot dS. This Q cancel out. So as a result, then E dot dS. So the change in potential is equal to E dot dS, which is the work is used to store the charges. So therefore, this is the negative. So this can be positive when we change the signs of the integral. So this delta V, this is from positive to negative. If we change it from negative to positive, this becomes positive. So this is equal to change in potential, or this is the potential difference between the plates. So the potential difference between the plates is equal to this. So here E is given. You just substitute the value of E. You substitute the value of dS. dS is its length, which gives the separation between the plates here. So as a resultant, you can find out easily the potential difference between the plates. So this is the electric field between the parallel plate capacitor. This is the potential between the parallel plates of the capacitor. And the previous equation was the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. So now we are looking at what is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. So now we are working on the calculation of the capacitance capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. So now if we look into this figure, if we consider the plates, these are the two plates, whose area is this? This is the plate, this is the plate. ये यहाँ पे मैं ये प्लेट बना रहा हूं, ये एक प्लेट है जिसका एरिया ये है, ये दिस इज द एरिया. ये मैंने एक प्लेट बनाई है, ये दिस इज द प्लेट. इस प्लेट का एरिया ए है, ये दूसरी प्लेट है, दोनों का एरिया सेम है और इन दोनों के दरमियान जो सेपरेशन है उसको मैं कह देता हूं डी है. इट मीन्स ए इज द एरिया ऑफ द प्लेट एंड डी, हियर डी इज द सेपरेशन बिटवीन द प्लेट्स या डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द प्लेट्स. So now we have to look at what is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. So here you have a formula that E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught, which is the electric field between the plates. E is equal to sigma is the charge per unit area. Charge per unit area is the sigma, because sigma is the charge per unit area. So I just plug in the value of the sigma, which is charge per unit area. So the equation becomes E is equal to Q upon A into epsilon. So now you know that, okay, what is the E? The voltage between the plates, the potential, let's say we call this is equation number one. The potential between the plates is V is equal to E into D. D is the separation between plates and E is the electric field between the plates. The potential is equal to E into D. जो हमने अभी discuss किया था कि potential V is equal to, याद होगा E dot ds. So this is E, integral over ds gives you the D, total distance. So the potential between the plates is equal to E into D. So V is equal to E. Substitute the value of E from equation number one. Value of E from equation 1. So we get V is equal to E, E is equal to Q upon epsilon naught A into D. So this V, according to the where, we know that Q is equal to CV, so V is equal to Q upon C. So this V is put it here. So therefore Q upon C is equal to Q upon epsilon naught A into D. So QQ cancel. If we take a reciprocal of it, C is equal to epsilon naught A over D. This is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. So this shows that C is equal to the epsilon naught A over D. This is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. This epsilon naught is the permittivity of the free space. This tells us about the medium. If the medium between the plates is air or vacuum, then we write it as a epsilon naught. And A is the area. It means if we increase the area of the plate, the capacitance or capability of storing the charges will increase. Okay? And if we increase the separation between the plates, if the plates are keeping away from each other, the D increases, so therefore the capacitance decreases. So therefore C is inversely proportional to D. So this is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. how we calculate the capacitance. Now, if we say that, if we place a, here we have an air, and this capacitance epsilon naught is for air and for vacuum. If we place a here a block of dielectric material over here, यहाँ इन प्लेट्स के दरमियान अगर डायइलेक्ट्रिक मटेरियल डाल देते हैं तो फिर क्या होगा? इफ इफ द ब्लॉक ऑफ डायइलेक्ट्रिक मटेरियल, डायइलेक्ट्रिक वी कॉल इट एज अ इंसुलेटर मटेरियल इज इंसर्टेड between the plates inserted between the plates then C is equal to epsilon naught into K of E A upon D. This K of E is another factor which is multiplied over there, which we call it as a dielectric constant, or which we call it as a permeability of the medium. This K E is known as dielectric constant. And its value for the medium is greater than one. Generally, आप लोग पढ़ के आए हो कि जो epsilon होता है, epsilon is equal to epsilon r into epsilon, epsilon r into epsilon naught. या इसको आप कह देते हैं k of r into epsilon naught. Air के लिए इसकी value one होती है. K of r is equal to one for air and vacuum. One for एयर या वैक्यूम. लेकिन यहां पे अगर मीडियम एयर वैक्यूम नहीं है तो दिस के आर इज ग्रेटर देन वन फॉर एनी डायलेक्ट्रिक मीडियम, एनी अदर डायलेक्ट्रिक मीडियम. So this is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. How to calculate the capacitance? If the air, if the medium between the plate is air, then the capacitance is equal to this. If the medium between the plates is a dielectric medium, the capacitance is increased. So the capacitance increases with the medium. Question is that how it increases? There is a phenomena we call it as the polarization of the material. This polarization of the material we will discuss in later on in the next topic. So now here K is the dielectric constant. So here this is the capacitance of the parallel plate capacitor. So now the capacitor may have different shapes. Capacitor may be the cylindrical capacitor. Capacitor may be the spherical capacitor. So now we have to look at how the capacitance can be calculated by using the cylindrical capacitor or spherical capacitor. So now we are looking at the capacitance of the cylindrical capacitor. So here this was the parallel plate capacitor. So now we are looking at the cylindrical capacitor. वी हैव अ सिलिंड्रिकल कैपेसिटर, फर्स्ट कर लेते हैं कि ये हमारे पास एक सिलेंडर है, दिस इज द सिलेंडर। इस सिलेंडर का जो रेडियस है विच वी कॉल इट इज अ बी, दिस इज द बी इज इट्स रेडियस। इसके अंदर एक और सिलेंडर है, इनर सिलेंडर, ये एक इनर सिलेंडर है, इसका जो रेडियस है यहां से यहां तक कुछ भी कॉल इट इज अ ए। सो ए इज द रेडियस ऑफ द इनर सिलेंडर एंड बी इज द रेडियस ऑफ द आउटर सिलेंडर। ए जो है, ए और बी रेडियस ऑफ इनर सिलेंडर एंड बी इज द रेडियस ऑफ आउटर सिलेंडर। इफ दीज टू सिलेंडर एंड द मीडियम बिटवीन देम इज एनी मीडियम, इसके दरमियान में जो मीडियम है वो एयर भी हो सकता है और कोई डायलेक्ट्रिक मीडियम भी हो सकता है। यहां पे हम सिंपल केस कर रहे हैं, इफ द मीडियम बिटवीन देम इज एयर। सो इफ द मीडियम बिटवीन देम इज एयर, we have to look at if what is the capacitance of this cylindrical capacitor. This is the positive terminal, this positive terminal is connected with the this is with the positive terminal, the inner cylinder is connected with the positive terminal and this outer cylinder is connected with the negative terminal. So therefore, this inner becomes a positively charged, this metal cylinder becomes a positively charged, and this outer is connected to the negative, so this is the negatively charged. So this is the cylindrical capacitor. So the electric field between them is varying from positive to negative. Like that, इसी को अगर मैं magnify करके बना देता हूँ, तो ये हमारे पास inner cylinder था, this is the positive, और ये हमारे पास outer cylinder है. This is the negative. The electric field is from positive to negative. The radius of this is B, the radius of this is A. So now we have to look at, okay, what is the electric field between the two cylinders? First, what is the potential between these two cylinders? This is the second. If we know the electric field and potential, then we easily find out the capacitance of this cylindrical capacitor. So now we have to work for this electric field and potential. So electric field can be found out by using Gauss's law. These are the electric line of force passing through the area of the cylinder. So using the Gauss's law, we can find out the electric field E. So the electric line of force passing through a unit area is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. This is the Gauss's law. This E integral over dA is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. This dA is the area of the cylinder, and area of the cylinder is equal to 2 pi r into length. This is the circumference, which is equal to 2 pi r. ये कोई भी हम r distance ले लेते हैं, r may be varies from A to B. Here, this here integral is from A to B. This is from A to B. So this E dot dA is equal to Q upon epsilon naught. So here in general this gives you the E क्या इंटीग्रल को आप पोटेंशियल निकाल देते हैं वो ज्यादा बेहतर होगा. यहां पे अगर आप ये देखें कि दिस ई इंटू डी ए इंटू डी ए इज इक्वल टू 2 पाई आर इंटू एल. दिस इज द एरिया ऑफ द सिलेंडर व्हिच इज इक्वल टू 2 पाई आर इंटू एल इंटू क्यू अपॉन एप्सिलॉन नॉट. E by using cross multiplication you can find out the value of E. So this E is equal to 1 upon 2 pi R L this 1 upon 2 pi R L into Q upon epsilon naught. This is the electric field between two cylinders. Here is the electric field. This is the electric field at a distance R. यहाँ पे electric field की जो value है वो ये. अब पोटेंशियल क्या है? व्हाट इज द पोटेंशियल हियर? व्हाट इज द पोटेंशियल है? पोटेंशियल को कैलकुलेट करना है. किस तरह से करें? वी पोटेंशियल इज डिफाइंड एज द इलेक्ट ई डॉट बी एस. दिस इज द पोटेंशियल. ये हम करके आए हैं. तो वी इज इक्वल टू ई क्या है? 1 अपॉन 4. मैं उस तरफ लिख देता हूं कि आपको इजी रहेगा. सो यहां पे अगर मैं कहूं कि v दिस v इज इक्वल टू e, e इज इक्वल टू 1 अपॉन 2 पाई आर एल 2 पाई आर एल Q upon epsilon naught into ds into ds. यहाँ पे ds है, यहाँ पे r है, तो you may write it as a dr. And this r is varying from this point to this point. This is r. This r varies from a to b. This r varies from a to b. So here the v can be rewritten as 1 upon 2 pi l common 1 upon 2 pi L, which is the length, which is common. Q upon epsilon naught is common. So the integral is 1 upon R into dr. And this integral is from A to B. So 1 upon R, 1 upon 2 pi L, Q upon epsilon naught, integral of 1 upon R is equal to log of R, which is from A to B. If you substitute the values of the limit, you will get V is equal to 1 upon 2 pi L Q upon epsilon naught log of B minus log of A. So log of B minus log of A is equal to log of B upon A. So here V is equal to 1 upon 2 pi L Q upon epsilon naught log of B upon A. So according to this, Q is equal to CV. We know that Q is equal to CV. V is equal to Q upon C. Compare. This is equation 2. This is equation 3. Compare 2 and 3. So we get Q upon C is equal to 1 upon 2 pi L Q upon epsilon naught log of V upon A. So if we compare this Q, Q cancel, take a reciprocal, C is equal to 2 pi L epsilon naught upon log of V upon A. This is the capacitance of the cylindrical capacitor. So this is the how to calculate the capacitance of the cylindrical capacitor. So here QQ cancel. 1 upon C is equal to 1 upon 2 pi L epsilon naught log of this. Iska reciprocal le to C is equal to ye bhi ulta ho jayega 2 pi L epsilon naught ye niche. So as a resultant, this is the capacitance of the cylindrical capacitor. So the cylindrical capacitance is directly proportional to the length and inversely proportional to the log of the diameters, log of the ratio of the diameters. This 2 pi is constant, epsilon naught is constant. The capacitance is directly proportional to the length. Jitni iski length zyada hogi, L is the length. Jitni iski length zyada hogi, utni capacitance zyada hogi. Dusri cheez, C is directly proportional to L. And C is inversely proportional to the log of B upon A. Means that the C depends upon the log of B upon A. Log function jo hota hai, usme small variation shows. The log shows a small variation. So the small, it varies the ratio of the radii of the cylinders. So this is the C, how C varies with the distance and with their radii. So this is the capacitance of the cylindrical capacitor. So now the next topic is the capacitance of the spherical capacitor. So instead of the cylindrical, so now we have to look at the spherical, which is our next topic.